Audio-Technica. Always listening.
This is Colin from 100 Reasons. I'm backstage at the Forum at the moment. We're just about to play the last show, I suppose, that we might play for quite some time, actually. Earlier in the year, we thought, let's try and at least go and have a proper send-off. And so these shows came about. So they've been amazing, actually. The crowds have just been awesome every night. You know, the fans have come out in their droves, which, you know, we're humbled by and we didn't expect. And it's kind of one of those things that's just genuinely heartwarming. We have our sound engineer, Mike. He's kind of been our sound engineer probably for about the last 3 or 4 years now, I think, actually, quite some time at least anyway. When we started these shows and what have you, he kind of came over and he said, you know, Audio-Technica kind of sent over these mics and stuff to give them a try. And you trust him. Sort of the previous mics I used didn't always necessarily have a lot of tone. You kind of do maybe 2 shows in and then, you know, you'd have to clean them or change the grills because they just got all clogged up and, you know, just the performance just took a massive nosedive. But since sort of Mike brought the 6100s in and stuff, the last couple of days have just been great. When you're in the studio, you get to go really close on the mic and you get all those tones that just make you feel sort of almost satisfied with what you're doing, if you see what I mean. But when you get on the 6100, it kind of feels very similar. So you just end up with this really warm sound. It gives you that extra bit of confidence. So that when you're playing live and, you know, like I said, you've got this wall of noise around you, you just feel, you know, you're cutting through it. Yeah, it's been really good.
100 Reasons are a pretty dynamic sort of rock band. It's not quite all full-on rock. They are very dynamic, very melodic kind of sounds. It needs to be a very solid band with Colin's vocal on top of it. Colin goes from hardly anything to really sort of quite shouty and loud in a, you know, full rock sort of way. And we need to be able to do all of that. That's the sort of sound that they have. I've always liked to have a condenser and a dynamic element on guitars. I think it works really well, and I've always used standard dynamics and usually 4050s or 4033s, whatever's available. So the 2500 came as a real sort of, it's a good thing to have on a guitar because you have the two capsules in one unit and they're both perfectly phase aligned, so you don't get any of that phase cancellation stuff that you do when you try and use separate elements. They just turn them up together and they're perfectly in line and they sound huge. There's such a range of sounds that Larry has, and you can get the best of all worlds out of the two elements with the dynamic and the condenser. You get a nice big full chunky sound from the condenser, and then you get the attack and the harder sort of edge to the guitar with the dynamic, and it really does work well with this band.
The most important thing for me with a guitar sound on stage is, I guess, trying to get it as vibrant and dynamic as it sounds when it's recorded coming through a PA system, which is tricky. So I think for that you need the right mic, the right amp, everything like that to get it sounding as if the PA is just a bigger version of your guitar cabinet. Which 2500 does very well. Yeah, it's a standard thing to do in the studio is use 2 microphones, use a condenser and a dynamic to capture different parts of the speaker tone, the tone and all the rest of it, which is always very difficult to do live. It just tends to be a nightmare with stands, getting the diaphragms lined up so the phase is right and all that stuff, and it just takes one misplaced backheel and it all goes horribly wrong. So it's a good design to have the 2 capsules in a single unit, which makes that a kind of foolproof in a way, which I think is unique and pleasing.